still out there. And if anyone ever needs any help, they don't need to come to Seattle for help. They can just stop by your blog anytime, because you really are a motivator.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. And I hope this is not last time we speak there in Skype. So I'm looking forward to make something special for Russians, and not only for Russians, with you and other interesting people we met in Facebook and other network connections.
Absolutely. Well, I have some good Americans over here that really know, even the people that I learned the business from, people that I really respect, that I'm sure would be interested in speaking. So I can always send contacts to you for a couple of people that John Lund, if you go to John Lund's blog, johnlund.com, and it's L-U-N-D, John does a really good job. He's a good friend, and when I was in school, I used to look at the leading photo magazine that we had at the time, and there was these photos done by this photographer called John Lund, and I was just so amazed by these photos. They were so incredible. He was one of the first real Photoshop masters, and this was 20 years ago. And then I got to be partners with him at Blend Images, and I can remember the first day him showing up, I felt like a kid, you know. I was just so excited to meet someone that had been so influential to me. And he turned out like all good people. He turned out to just be like a regular guy, you know. And I find that with all the really good photographers, they're really open to sharing information and mentoring the younger people coming up in the industry. It's definitely been a standard in our industry for years, and I see you uphold it. And I'm glad to see there's still people that are coming along that realize. My teacher once told me, he said, if you give away all your secrets, you have to come up with new ones. So give them all away, and it will keep you thinking.
Yes, and that's great.
I've always kept that to heart.
So, it will be very nice to meet your friends and people who want to share their information. So, you can send me links and contacts in Facebook or even here. So,
absolutely.
I will.
I'll think of some of my favorite people that put on a good show and are friendly and also very talented. Because I think that's what makes for a good speaking, is being happy but also having a little experience to share. And the more people you gain experience from, I think the stronger you become. You know, the more sources of education, the better.
Yes.
So,
this is...
you just keep shooting, man. Get your winter gear on right now and go out there in the 30 below and take some pictures.
I made something. I can send you a link. I was shooting a few days ago. It was really cold, and all my models were speaking me how bad I am to
make them
to get them outdoors and shoot in such cold weather. So yes, but I'm a little bit crazy, so it doesn't matter.
But crazy
for me
is good. You see, yeah. Crazy is part of this business.
Yeah.
You know, I can remember back when we used to shoot catalogs for clothing companies, they generally had to be done in advance for the season by a good 6 months, so they could put them all together and have them ready for the season. So one year, they didn't fly us down to California to shoot. They were on a tighter budget, and they shot us at a golf course shooting summer clothes, and there was frost on the green. It was so cold. We were shooting in the winter for the summer catalog. And so when they laughed or spoke, out come these plumes of steam from their mouth, you know? So I had to make them laugh in. I had to...
Yeah, you know, so no smoke, this was before we had Photoshop.
So talk about crazy, man. Yeah, no, cold is not good for the camera or the body.
Yes.
So enjoy the evening.
Yes, if you want, I have another question.
Yes.
New idea. How do you think, is it really good when photographers have education in photographic colleges or something like that?
I think the more knowledge you can gain directly and personally, be it studying under another photographer who's already done it, today the education and blogs have filled a large gap. but there's something about being on hands and watching a photographer light. I think lighting is the part of the equation that seems to be slipping away a little bit. The ability to be really good and make whatever light you want so that it's not a concern, so that you can have the opportunity to see any picture in your mind. Or if you get to a location, we did a skate park this year. We got there with the kids. It had rained that night. There was water on the skate park for skateboards, and the owner of the skateboarding place would not let us skate. So we had to change it all up. And by doing that, I had to use 14 lights to light this place. I mean, fortunately, we have them at this point in our career, but to know how to use them is the most important part, even if it's just one light. And knowing also where good light is outdoors, because there are some standard locations all over the world that we all share. If you go into a doorway where the light has to come in and at the person instead of down, we're forcing, if you look at light like almost like raindrops that can curve, if you get a person in, the light has to come in at their face, which opens their face. If you put them out in the light, it comes straight down on them, and the eyes get dark. So anytime you can put somebody back in the open shadow a little bit, but the light has to come in to get to the face, you'll have much cleaner light. So, yeah, I think there's a lot of opportunity to make great images with just a camera.
And
but
practice.
The ability to learn, not just, it's hard, you know, the hardest place, the thing to learn, I think, in this business is the business part. Because even when you work for a photographer, they don't share much of that with you. And the best place to learn that, I think, is in school. Even in a business course, it doesn't have to be directly photographically related. Just to understand how to make plans, business plans, how to properly finance your company, and what you need to get over the hump. You can learn those in standard business courses and adapt them to your photography. But education is the key to everything, I think. The more education, I would not hesitate right now to go take an educational class myself. If the opportunity came up, I'm just a glutton for information. Sometimes you'll spend an hour listening to someone and they're just like, yeah, I've heard it all. And then they say one thing and you haven't heard it. And it's just, I call them nuggets of gold. And they're just like these little nuggets. You pan the river all day. All you get is dirt and silt, and suddenly a nugget comes up, and that one nugget goes into your bag. And, you know, what did it take you? An hour of your life. The other information wasn't as helpful. Just like what I say today, some people will hear and go, yeah, I know that. But hopefully someone will hear something they hadn't heard before. And that's the gift of education. The more, the better.
Yes, so practice is the best in education.
The best. Fail. I say embrace failure. Make it your friend. Be willing to love it. And because the biggest thing that keeps us from going out and doing it is fear of failure. I believe that in just about everyone, even myself. And everyone I've seen, even the people above myself, which there are a lot of, I see that fear is our biggest battle, fear of failing and not getting the shot you really wanted. I think you just need to go out and have fun. Because when you're having fun, the brain really saturates and really learns. So have fun. If you're not having fun, you've got the wrong attitude.
Yes,
you need
I
to
think
go out,
it's not only
just need to go out and have fun and not take it too seriously. And then it grows all on its own. It's like watering a plant every day. You know, you don't think about it, you just do it. And then eventually you have fresh lemons in the summer, you know, or something.
Yes,
hopefully,
it's so,
for all your work.
Yes, it's so. So, thank you. Thank you so much talking
to me. I hope it was a help.
Yes, yes, it's really useful information. So, and I hope we will make something like that in the future, in a new year, but a complete conference without any troubles with connection. So, each Pooh.
Each person can be
Each
on.
person, yes.
Yes,
I'm freezed.
we have a very good conference calling system that we use here that I can always send along to you if you're looking for something US-based, but you're probably looking for something Russian-based that can hook up to US
Yes.
because you've really only got a few
Yes,
of us. You
we
spoke with
have
Ellen today, who just lives about 50 miles from me.
Yes, we also have some there, so I think we will prepare better than this time, and it will be good.
I'm
I'm
curious if I
praying
may
for
ask one question.
it.
With all the people you interviewed today, did you seem to find a similar approach from everyone, or do you think it's really across the board? Everybody have a different approach, or do we kind of see things in similar light?
I think it's a different approach.
Yeah, good. That's the best thing. You see, I want people to realize that what I say is just a little information. It's not set in stone, and as Ellen's or anyone else that spoke. You just find what works for you the best, you know? And that's found by just listening a lot and
Yes.
taking what works. Yeah,
Different
so go enjoy
opinions.
your evening. You've been doing this for a long time. I'm sure you're tired. But I look
I'm
forward to the new year, and please include me. I would love to be part of it.
okay. I'm not so tired. I'm really freezed. It's cool outdoors, but it's cool to hear you too, but in different
Yeah.
meanings.
Well, go put on your sweater and drink a hot cup of coffee, and thank all your viewers a great deal for taking their time to listen today. I get as much out of it as I hope they do.
Okay.
It really motivates me a great deal.
Okay, thank you, and see you soon,
Cheers,
I
Krill, and we'll
hope.
speak soon.
Cheers.
Bye-bye.
Bye.